people of the Purple Butterfly here, otherwise known as people of 7 on Twitter and YouTube, people are elsewhere on the internet. My soaps are located at purplebutterfly-soaps.myshopify.com. And by popular request, the almond milk and turmeric soap that's curing over there and won't be ready for almost a month, people have been saying, can I get it sooner? Can I get it sooner? Can I get it sooner? And the 8 bars that are curing over there, people have already requested it and put forth interest. And basically, that entire batch is sold. So I'm making a new batch, exact same recipe, except for I'm going to hot process it. So that way it will be ready tomorrow. And then I only have to cure for, you know, less than a week. And that will be on sale immediately. So I've already put the coconut oil and the turmeric, and the turmeric has already been infusing for a day, and the olive oil and everything together. I've already made the lye water, and basically we're going to get it going. Heating up, so that way, you know, it's a process. The reason they call it hot process soap is because, and unlike cold process, you cook it until it's no longer, till the lye is no longer active. At that point, you have soap that's ready to go the same day. Let me put my gear on. And then come over here and get the lye water, which is actually milk. Almond milk. And a little bit of water. This is still hot, but you don't have to cool down or wait on the lye when you're doing hot process. You just go ahead and pour it in. But just like I do with cold process, I'm going to strain it, because that way little curds of curdled milk doesn't get in my finished product. There we go. Only is hot process quicker than cold process. The technique is quicker. This is where it is traced. And it cooks for 30 minutes. I'll check on your green. Cooks until I go on all the stages, and then at some point in time, roughly an hour from now, it'll be completely 100% done. And that orange color is back. That's because actually the orange color is darker because the milk is being cooked by the lye. And then the turmeric is bright golden, bright yellow. So yeah, that's the cause of that. Almond milk, turmeric, a little bit of water. got the titanium dioxide. Hold on. A little bit of soy bean oil and coconut oil. Usually I put the titanium dioxide in with the lye water or lye milk. But I completely forgot. Trace. Time you go to scrape the stick blender, disconnect it from the power. Whether it's hot process or cold process, that's important. It keeps you from, you know, losing fingers and such. There, so it can get cleaned later. And then I'm going to come over here and get the lid, which I actually have right next to it, for the coffee. Yeah. So that's going to cook for a while. I'm not going to expect you to sit around and wait an hour for this to reach the next stage, which would be either Vaseline stage or mashed potato stage, depending on how long it cooks. So I'll just bring you back.
Be allowed to enjoy this. I should be more supportive.
And if the university has given him a PhD, they must feel he is a worthy recipient.
Hey,
applesauce stage.
Detroit style pizza with the cheese all the way to the crispy edges. Layered with 80, no they didn't, 80 pepperonis. And a savory sauce
took 10 minutes.
Right on top.
I put the lid on at 4:35. It's 4:45 exactly at the moment.
Thank you. The Detroit style pizza. Create your own or pick from three signature recipes. No one else.
Separating is the same. Yeah, blend it. That's why I have two stick blenders. Sometimes when you're doing hot process, you can literally burn out your blender when it gets thicker. I have two stick blenders, so that way if one burns out, I got the other. Got to mute the sound. Can't get a strike for copyrighted material being on my video. Yeah, that would not be fun.
on the soap that was stuck to the beater. Once it reaches this stage, it basically pulls all the extra off. So that way it can continue cooking and get every last bit of it integrated. Beat it clean past mashed potato stage. So now I'm going to cook it until it reaches Vaseline stage. I swear whoever invented the stages of cold processed soap must have been hungry when they did it. Because all the stages except for one has food names. That is hot.
That's going to cook for another 20 minutes or so. Bring you back. I hear a popping sound, so it's time to check on it. Potato stage. Although since it's turmeric and it's orange, it looks like sweet potato stage, huh? I don't know if you can hear it, but it's making like a sizzling sound. That's because of the level of the heat. But it's fine. Cold process makes all kinds of sounds and has all kinds of stages. From applesauce to mashed potatoes to Vaseline. Yep. And I'll bring you back. Okay, the video cut off because there was an emergency phone call. I have my phone set for do not disturb with the exception of emergencies. So when the phone rang, it cut off the video. I knew it was important. So, yeah. In the meantime, the soap is primarily done. So I'm going to go ahead and put it in the mode. That's Vaseline stage. See how shiny?
hear that sizzling. Because I used a different mold and then used this frame, and it was the wrong size. But this is the mold that goes with the frame, so that won't be an issue. The trick now is just to get it in the mold. Easy, since in my brain I'm still in a rush. Even when you're in a rush, you still have to do things a certain way so you have a good outcome. And on that, I'm failing at the moment because, well, my brain's going there. About soap making is it makes its own cleanup. So the only thing I have to do is add some water, and this will be easy to clean up because, well, it's soap. Now I need to tap this down. Trying to smooth it actually. Give me a second, because there's one step I do, whether it's hot process or cold process, you gotta slam it. Fortunately, I live on the ground floor of my apartment, so I don't have to worry about disturbing my neighbors when I do that. If I had neighbors below me, I would just offer them a bar of soap, so that way it would alleviate the annoyance of hearing my soap slam every now and then. Or I probably wouldn't worry about it, because the neighbor that's above me makes all kinds of noise and doesn't bother me a bit. That's the finished product. Yes. Now, even though I don't have to cover it because it's hot process and it's fully cooked, I'm still going to put the shield on it and let it cool down. So that way, if there's any steam, as you can tell there is, I won't lose any of the good stuff that's in there, because the steam will hold all the moisture and send it back down, so that way it doesn't evaporate too quickly and make a dry, cruddy soap. Because nobody wants a dry, cruddy soap. I want it to be just as moist as the cold process, and I have to worry about whether or not the soap is going to be compromised. So that's why I follow those guidelines. In the meantime, let me bring you over here. I'm gonna do a lather test. This is fully cooked, by the way. Got a and as you can tell, my recipe makes a whole lot of bubbles. That piece over there for you to enjoy.
There's been People of Seven on Twitter and YouTube, people elsewhere on the internet. My soaps, Purple Butterfly Soaps, can be located at purplebutterfly-soaps.myshopify.com. Y'all stay blessed, stay tuned. Bye now. And that's how it looks. That's what you call that rustic look. Yes. Enjoy. This will be available. I'm cutting it tomorrow. And once it's completely solid, it's for sale.